Karen McGinnis, CNN weather. You've been watching CNN's The Big Story, but we have a storm to tell you about in the Pacific, in the Western Pacific. Typhoon Omar moved across the U.S. territory of Guam. We've had a lot of folks who've called up asking us about Typhoon Omar. It hit the island with 150 mile an hour winds, or just about 130 knots. It is now moving towards the west, slightly northwest, and could affect perhaps the Philippine Islands over the next several days. 80 people were injured on the island of Guam. It flattened buildings, flooded streets. The USS White Plains and the USS Niagara Falls were pulled from their moorings and reportedly went aground, but we don't have any reports of any injuries from that, but we'll keep you updated. Lots of showers across Southeast Asia, also across China, and into sections of Japan. Karen McGinnis, CNN weather. You've been watching CNN's The Big Story, but we have a storm to tell you about in the Pacific, in the Western Pacific. Typhoon Omar moved across the U.S. territory of Guam. We've had a lot of folks who've called up asking us about Typhoon Omar. It hit the island with 150 mile an hour winds, or just about 130 knots. It is now moving towards the west, slightly northwest, and could affect perhaps the Philippine Islands over the next several days. 80 people were injured on the island of Guam. It flattened buildings, flooded streets. The USS White Plains and the USS Niagara Falls were pulled from their moorings and reportedly went aground, but we don't have any reports of any injuries from that, but we'll keep you updated. Lots of showers across Southeast Asia, also across China, and into sections of Japan.